Hello YouTubers, welcome to another video. In this video, I'm going to show you this recent purchase of this Sanwa CX-506 multi-tester or multimeter. It's an analog type. It's sold with its original box, and I got a good deal for it because of the last minute information from the seller itself through my friend, saying that it has some faultiness in it, but currently I do not know what's wrong with it. I just got the multimeter, and very nice that it has its it still has the original box, so I'm feeling that it's like buying new old stock, something like that. There is another model which is a newer one than this, which is has an alphabet A. So those are quite pricier than this. So since this one was a good deal, so I just snatched this one. So for around, I think, let me try to remember, maybe 5 to 10 USD, around there, I think. Yeah. So we're gonna proceed to unboxing the thing. Yeah. The it has still has the bubble wrap with it, and still has the instruction manual, which is I believe Sanwa is professional about writing booklet for their test gear or multimeter and that sort of thing. So we're not gonna go to the instruction manual. There's a probe here, so I'm not sure whether this is the original probe. It looks vintage, you know, this kind of style that has the thread here. So let me try to focus the camera better. Yeah, so maybe it didn't have much use from its previous owner. Maybe it has some, because there's some bent. Anyway, this is normal. It happens when you use multimeter, so I don't complain about that. The wire is quite it's quite thin actually, so I don't know whether this is the original probe that comes with it. Well, anyway, this is the analog meter. So already I'm seeing something awkward here. Needle always going on in the reverse. Let me try to focus properly. Needle already going, and also avoid the glare from my ceiling light. So needle already going to the left. So I'm not sure whether this is a good sign or not. Let's play with the so the rotary selector seems very, I don't know whether I can say this feels new or what, but yeah, I'm not sure what is this. I will read the manual. The polarity switch, this is the what is this, ohms adjustment. I think this is adjusting the needle. It has an LED there, continuity, which I like, so it's a bonus actually. I think nowadays I'm not sure whether all analog multimeter still include LED and continuity LED. So the appearance is very satisfactory. I believe the owner took care of it well. So but before I go and test, I'm sure, because from the past information that was relayed to me, it has some problem. Let's open up the case before we go and use this immediately for work. It has a threaded stainless steel, I believe, very shiny. I'm not sure whether I don't think this is replaced. So yeah, very good, very high quality. It's a one screw job to access the cover. Okay, already we see something interesting, and on the case also. This thing happened anyway. People tend to forget about the battery inside of their test equipment. So there's some leakage. I'm not sure whether you can see this. Let me try to focus. there's some leakage liquid I believe from the battery itself. So yeah, I think it's coming from this old GP AA battery. But anyway, the overall look of it is very very nice, very very, let me take something to point, something that is not metal, a pen or something, or a pencil, yeah, pen. So very nice, using believe this is metal film resistor. There's a fuse there. I'm not sure whether this fuse is blown. Now I remember that the owner of this multimeter told my friend that was doing the purchase for me, it has some blow or some of the maybe one of the selector doesn't correspond to the thing. So I'm suspecting this switch blow or what. Let me take a multimeter and another multimeter and check this. What better than to check a Sanwa with another Sanwa? So okay, continuity. So there's, look at the light. So there's no sound. That means there is a blown. How do I do this? Now I know why this probe is not good, because you cannot do chopstick. Very difficult because of this thing. This is a cheap probe, not from Sanwa. So yeah, you cannot do chopstick style. So yeah, this is the fuse. There's a spare fuse here. Let me take that and try. This is good. Okay, as proof. So you can look at the light. Yeah. Okay, let's not annoy the viewers. So we're gonna put this spare fuse on its place. I really want to save this spare fuse and try to find the replacement for this to replace this. So the leakage is the battery leakage is let me try to focus. Yeah, forgive me what to do, cheap camera. So the leakage, the oxidation, or the whatever you may call this, is originates from the battery itself. I don't think this one is I think this one is doing a bit better than the let me do some tongue test. Clearly no power. Okay, dead. So this one, let's take out the GP. So this operates with a 9 volt and two piece of AA, which equals to 12 volt. So this is the serial number. So I'm not sure it's made in what year, which batch. So yeah, so I'm gonna cut this video and proceed cleaning this, and maybe I'll do another video and try to patch this video to that video. And see you on the next video. Yeah, of the Sanwa CX-506. Yeah, thank you very much and bye bye.